Hi. What up, though? How y'all doing out there? How's your Valentine's Day? I haven't got to talk to you about that shit. How's your Valentine's Day? Did you go in? Did you go the fuck in? Did you have a good one? Did you chill? Did you have a nice quiet one with the family? Tell me. Talk to me. Tell me what you did. Tell me what you did. Mine was good. We just chilled. She cooked. And we just ate Molly and went ham. And that was fun. So if I'm stupid this week, that's just the hangover. That's just the fucking happiness drained out of my body. I actually don't feel that unhappy. It's just the fucking the little Molly hangover. Worth it though. Fucking fun. Laid around all day, watched The Godfather. I feel like probably I watch it more than most people because I'm Italian. Like, just. I've watched that 3-hour movie way more than the average Joe, I imagine. So, yeah, it was cool. Ate leftovers, watched The Godfather, chilled. And now I'm here with you.
How far do you go with that? Do you get gifts? Chocolates? Roses?
I had told her she had like a record player, so like I pulled some records from my collection that I thought that she would like more than I would like, and I just gave her that. That was it. That was all. And then she cooked. And then we chilled. That was all. I like she's my girl, so you know what I mean?
Seems like it's getting there, but
well, I'm working at it, you know. Like I'm working at it, John. Fucking takes me a while to get to these things, man. I got fucking issues, so I'm like a feral dog. You just got to keep feeding me and don't try to grab me. You know what I mean?
Lone wolf.
Yeah, and then I'll come in the house sooner or later. Like, so, yeah.
She get you anything?
No, she just brought food and cooked.
I know.
So, shout out to my man, Kev. I feel like such a dick, but we drank Kev's wine. The wine that Kev made. And I don't even know the name of it off the top of my head. Because I'm a fucking asshole. But she liked it very much. And my mom came by and drank the rest. Bam.
Sounds like a traditional Valentine's Day.
Well, I mean, she didn't come over that day. She came over today and drank the rest of the wine. Might have some more. Have some fucking more. Drink up. Don't want it to go to waste. Anybody call?
Not worth speaking to yet. Which
too bad. Too bad none of y'all's shit was fucking hype enough to get on the air. Wah, wah, wah. Wah, 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 wah. Wonder if anybody had a bad Valentine's Day. I think there was, I don't know if this was true or not, but it was like Single People Appreciation Day or some shit. Like, Single People Day. What day is that? Monday, February 15th. How pathetic.
What's the wrong with being single?
I know, but like, that's, doesn't that seem just pathetic?
Yeah. I mean, they're just.
That's pathetic. That's fucking pathetic, dog. As somebody that's been single for fucking 10 years, I don't need a day.
It's not fair. The couples have a day. Why don't I have a day?
Singles day. Ugh. Who came up with that?
A sexologist somewhere, I'm sure.
Single Awareness is celebrated February 15th each year. It is an unofficial holiday celebrated by single people. It serves as a compliment to Valentine's Day for people who are single and not married or in a romantic relationship. You fucking bitches. You got to come up with a day right afterwards. Doesn't that just scream fucking insecure?
What about our day? It's not fair. I'm tired of these couples being happy.
First off, Valentine's Day is kind of a pain in the ass for fucking half the, like, you got to go do all this shit. And I get it, it's a fucking Hallmark holiday. I understand. Like, I understand that shit. But, like, unless you and your girl are on the same page, you better fucking do something. And I don't know any girl that's, like, gonna turn down a gift. Even if she's like, hey, fuck that, it's a Hallmark holiday. And, like, you show up with a gift. I don't know any girl that'd be like, pissed off. I told you it's a Hallmark holiday. Take that fucking mink back. Take that mink back. It's a Hallmark holiday. God damn it. I guess people that say it's a Hallmark holiday wouldn't be wearing mink. They'd be wearing like fucking something made out of hemp. Some fair trade hemp shirt. Take back that fair trade hemp shirt. That no animals were harmed. Fuck that shit. If you celebrated Singles Day, smack yourself in the face right now. God damn it.
BP out of Chicago did not celebrate Singles Day. If you want to talk to him for a second.
BP, what up, though?
What up, man? My girl was on her period, though, but she gave me, like, the dopest head. Like, she just made up for it. Plus, I had to give her some Pandora shit, but... Hey,
what's Pandora shit? What is that? Is that like a sex?
You know, like, no, the Pandora, the jewelry shit.
Oh, word. Oh, yeah. I forgot about Pandora. Like, I always get confused. All right. Yeah, that's that popular shit that the girls like.
Right.
Yeah.
Right.
All
right.
So you got, she was happy with the jewelry and then she gave you a bomb head. You're not into,
well,
like,
yeah,
just,
she.
Why don't you just throw the towel down and fucking fuck on
the
towel?
Nah, bro, she just got it on that specific day. Like, on Saturday she got it. So it was like, oh, you know. And I'm like, you know what? It's all good. I'm just, you know what I mean? Just give me some head, bro. She went over the top with it. She made it up.
That's right. You could have had the room looking like a Valentine's Day massacre, but you just got some head instead.
That's what I told her.
I remember my ex one time. She got put on some fucking birth control that was making her bleed, and we didn't see that shit, and fucked in a Hard Rock in Chicago, and it looked like. Dog, it looked like murder. It was so bloody that they didn't even bill us, like, because they didn't want to fucking talk about it. There was like red handprints on the fucking wall, like blood stains everywhere.
Oh,
fucking
Lord.
Nuts. I know. Well, I didn't know. Like, it was dark. We were fucking in the dark, and I woke up in the daytime and was like, oh my God, dude. It's like a murder scene.
No, I felt something. I'm like, yo, you know, your shit just came down. Like, I can't even do this. So we just had to clean it up real quick. And then just, you know, she ain't stopped the show.
That's cool. Yeah, I can do the fucking period sex. I just don't like period sex doggy style because it just goes right in your nose. Other than that, like, I'm... The pussy's got its own fucking climate down there. Like, it changes smells throughout the fucking month and shit. And the period smell is not the best. But that's dope that you got head. Congratulations. And that you got a fucking good one.
Thank you, bro.
Yeah, that's even better than the head, the fact that you got a good one. It's like, you know what? Fuck this shit. I got you. I'm gonna put it down.
Boy, a lot of people did stuff. Got Trey out of Chicago.
Chi-Town, what up?
What's going on, Jude? Man, I had a really great Valentine's Day. I had took my girl to a rooftop bar downtown. the Roby Hotel. It was nice, intimate, man. And then we just had drinks there for a little bit, nice little dinner. And then afterwards, we went to like a nightclub where it was just like basically as if COVID never existed. People weren't wearing masks and stuff. It was like guys doing coke in the bathroom, man. But like outside of all that crazy stuff, me and my girl, we had a great time, man. You know, it, like awesome. I don't have nothing bad to say, man. It was real intimate. You know, I just had a kid, so I just really wanted to show my appreciation to my girlfriend.
That's awesome, dog. That's fucking, and isn't it cool just to be in a place where like everyone's not on edge and shit, and they're just fucking chilling, and like you're like, oh yeah, damn, this is man. What this is what yeah. fucking yeah. normal felt like. Yeah, I forgot that feeling. Exactly. Like, yeah,
exactly. Yeah. And then you got like people were doing just crazy stuff, and it was like me and my girl, we were in our own world, man. We were just like, people were just walking up to us, like we were just vibing out, dancing. People just coming up to us like, oh, what are they doing? We just like, fuck out of here. We're just dancing, just vibing, man. So it was a right. good time, man. You know, I just wanted to come up here and just call and tell you how my Valentine's went.
Well, thank you for calling, and congrats on being a new dad and fucking making a family. That's what matters. As I get older, my perception has changed, and that's my new shit. It's family. Family, family.
Wow, family first.
For real, bro. Like,
I don't mean to laugh. It's nice. It's a good.
I'm
thought.
Telling you, man. Like, I was out there in L.A. I took a look around. I was like, I got a lot of shit, and that's all it is stuff. It's just stuff. It's meaningless.
What the hell did I do? I rode my bike in a drainage ditch for Valentine's Day. So. There you go.
Did you fall?
No, I did not. Nope. Just
why'd you ride in the ditch? You just like just you were just riding in the ditch.
Well, the,
or just you yeah. crashed in that ditch.
No, it's the at the LA River.
Yeah. That's cool. Yeah. That's not bad.
Screwing around. Didn't find any bodies, but just cruising around. Did not find love, but there's Jackson in. He's saying Dubai. I have my doubts, but
Jackson.
Yo, Jude.
What's up, man?
I was beefing my girl all Valentine's.
What was y'all fighting about?
All right, I woke up. I turned on the PlayStation. She got triggered because all I'm thinking is my day off, but she woke up thinking it's Valentine's Day. So her first reaction is, "Where's my flowers?" And my first reaction is, "I'm gaming out," you know.
Yeah,
and then we got in a big ass argument telling me, "Where's my flowers?" I'm like, "Where's my flowers?" And then she's trying to tell me, like, "You're supposed to buy me shit." I'm like, "You're supposed to buy me shit." And she's not agreeing with me. So what do you think?
You're supposed to buy her shit.
Settle this argument for us, please.
You're wrong. I hate to say, like, look, man, like, Valentine's Day, her birthday, Christmas, and if you got, she got a kid, Mother's Day, those are like the four ones you need to nail. Whether you believe in fucking God or not, like those are just the four ones you need to fucking nail, bro. Yeah, you fucking. It would have been so much. All you had to do was go pick up some fucking flowers for her ass, like.
but why don't I get shit? Like I don't get no fucking chocolates or nothing.
Yeah, shit ain't fair, dog. Yeah, guess who gets to get blown up in wars? Men. Like shit ain't fair. Like.
That's a big fact.
Yeah. We also get to put our dick in things. You know what I mean? Like you also get to go fuck things, like, and not get fucked. So that's there you go. Like there's ups and every like there's pluses and minuses for each sex. And unfortunately,
I'm proud to be a man, bro.
Yeah, well, fuck, next time get her some shit for fucking Valentine's Day, like. That's what I was telling Kat. I said it on fucking Friday. I was like, even if you don't celebrate that shit, they do, bro. Just fucking err on the side of caution.
You know, my girl snapping her fingers at me right now because of you, bro. You picked the wrong side, my nigga.
Man, go take her somewhere today. Be like, my bad. Let me take you somewhere today. Like, and then the thing is like, you hook them up on Valentine's Day, and if they're not, if they're fucking quality chicks, man, they'll fucking hook you up throughout the fucking, they'll hook you, they'll get your back, you know what I mean? Like, I think that you should be sure, I think couples should show fucking affection to one another all throughout the year. Shouldn't be relegated to one day, but on Valentine's Day, like, everyone's doing it, and if you don't, it just fucking makes things complicated for yourself, just out of ease. Don't you want shit to be easy for yourself? What's harder, going to the store and grabbing her a fucking bouquet or some candy or some of her favorite perfume or some shit, or fucking screaming on each other at 10 in the morning over why you're trying to play PS5? Fucking
didn't really think that one through.
There's right and there's wrong, and then there's easy and there's hard, you know what I mean? And sometimes you can just pick wrong and easy, you know what I mean? Like, you might not agree with Valentine's Day, but it's just easier to fucking get them this shit. Like, here, take this. Happy Valentine's. Happy Valentine's. There you go. And when in doubt, like, if people ever get to go back to work, send the flowers to the job so that they can flex on all the other girls.
I've seen that. I've had mixed feelings about that, but I think you're right.
Isn't it, dog, send the flowers to the girl at work, because that's what it's all about. It's all about appearances, man. She is loved. Sending flowers to her, she is loved. Yeah. Now, it might get tricky if she works at a flower shop, but other than that, like, and if that's the case, send her like an edible arrangement or some shit like that, something that the flower shop doesn't fucking carry. I don't know. But like, send her something that all the other women in the office or in her workplace can look at and be fucking know that she is loved.
Oh, I know. It's a celebration when they drop off those edible bouquets and the women shriek, like, oh, Bad Debbie.
Yeah. She's the star of the show, and all the other ladies are like happy for her, but then secretly jealous too. You know what I mean? They're like, ah, that's great, but they're like low key fucking mad that their man ain't do it. And you get a fucking blowjob when she gets home, and all the other dudes get fucking the cold shoulder.
It's an investment.
Fuck, I'm telling you, man.
Do you want to talk to somebody else?
Yeah, give me one more. Why not? Why the fuck not?
Patrick over in Stockton.
Patrick in Stockton, what's up, man?
And I'm a long time listener, first time caller.
What's up, bro?
Jude, I got a little bit of a beef with you, man.
Go ahead.
We celebrated Valentine's Day on Saturday because I had to work Sunday. But Valentine's Day is a celebration. Yeah,
oh, yeah, keep going. Yeah, keep going. I'm listening.
Valentine's Day is a celebration of love, man, for lovers. This thing where these guys are just buying their girl something, and then the girl, okay, you get a blowjob or something for your Valentine's gift. Man, that shit ain't cool, man. Valentine's Day should work both ways, bro. Sex ain't sex. That's joint in a relationship. You know what I mean?
I agree. Look, I'm not
giving her guys something too, man.
I don't disagree with you. But if anyone's gonna get it, let's just say it this way. I was putting it out this way in that, like, if one person's gonna get the gift, if only one person's gonna get a gift, make it the girl. That's all I'm saying. Like, in my Valentine's relationships, especially like when they're my girlfriend, like, we're giving each other things, you know what I mean? But like, it is a celebration of love. It's not just for the girl, but it It kind of is. And if you got a down ass chick, she'll.
But see, that's what makes it rough. You know, when you say, you know, get the girl something, make sure the girl's getting something. But see, Jude.
If you got a good, but like, look, I don't need shit, and there's nothing this girl can get me that is gonna make me fucking happy. So her coming over and cooking for me while I gave her some fucking albums and stuff, like, I was good with that. Like, I didn't need shit else. Like, I
that was cool, Jude. That was perfect. That was perfect, bro. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. So like,
what I'm saying is, you know, these guys are whining and dining their girls and all that. And at the end of the night, you know, when you wake up the next morning, you think about it, you're like, okay, Valentine's Day just passed. I bought my girl this and did that. And then the dude wakes up and says, damn, okay, I got a blowjob. But I get a blowjob all the time.
Yeah, I agree with that. But here's the deal, like, I didn't want to hype my man up about things not being fair. He seemed happy with the blowjob, so like, yo, if he's happy with the fucking blowjob, then that's he's good. Unfortunately, chicks aren't happy with just getting ate and out. That's like, you just going down on them for a minute is not gonna fucking, it's not gonna seal the deal. So you seem like a man that's into fairness. You know what I mean? Like, you just want shit to be fair. And I'm on the same page as you, but
I do, man. And yeah. You had to call her. You had to call her. That call before that, though. A guy from Chicago. It said he took his girl out. They went on a rooftop. They had a good time. You know what, man? That sounded the new father. He sounded very happy, and that's what this shit is all about.
Yeah. But he didn't tell me what she gave him, so like, for all we know, she didn't get him shit. But like, they enjoyed each other.
That's a strong possibility.
You know, she gave him a child. That's fucking priceless.
Yeah,
you know,
he was very content with that and very happy, man. And that, right. And at the end of the day, though, that's what it's all about, man. Are you happy?
Yeah, exactly. And it just depends on where, like, To be completely honest with you, like, I'm such a pain in the ass to shop for. Like, I don't even want the chick to try to buy me some shit, because I don't want to have to wear some fucking shirt that I don't like. You know what I mean? Like, just to make her happy.
Yeah.
You never wear my Valentine's shirt. Like, yeah, because I know how to shop for my fucking self. You know what I mean? Like.
Yeah, but you, the coolest shit in the world is getting flowers from a chick, bro.
Yeah. All right. Yeah, I guess I would prefer flowers to a fucking shirt, because like, the flowers die after a while. They'll just hang up in my closet for a mad long time. Why don't you wear that polo I got you? Because it's red and I got pink undertones. I look like shit. Yeah. In red. Yeah. I know. Yeah. What's that?
I'm going to take all your time, man. I'm about to go to a dead spot. But it's been absolute pleasure. My son's going to have a fit when he find out I talked to you.
Well, cool. Right. I'm glad you had a good Valentine's yourself. All right, let's play some music. Come on back. It is the All Out Show on Shade 45.
You're listening to the All Out Show with you.
What up, though? It's your boy Judy. How you doing out there? How you doing? How's everyone doing? If you're doing good, you don't need me. Fucking pat yourself on the back. You're winning at life. If you're doing bad, you're going through some shit, and you need to fucking straighten it out, call up right now. 888-742-3345. Now, these are the problems that I handle. I handle fucking boyfriend, girlfriend, girlfriend, boyfriend, mom and dad, kid, job, shit like that, friends, all of that. I don't do legal, okay? You wouldn't want, honestly, if you're calling up a fucking afternoon drive guy for legal advice, you got real issues that are bigger than me. So don't call up about no legal shit. Other than that, I got you. I can hold you down. I've been through a lot. I've seen a lot. And I'm here for you. All you got to do is dial 888-742-3345, and I will life coach the shit out of you, son. Dun, dun. Now, let's go. It's Shea 45, All Out Show. What would you do? Coming up next.
You're listening to the All Out Show with you.
It's like a ray of light beaming down knowledge from the heavens above.
What would you do? Need advice?
Call us up right now.
Now. 888-SHADE-45. What would you do?
SHADE-45.
SHADE-45, it's your boy Judy. I'm here to fucking save your goddamn life. Call up right now. What would you do? You got a problem? Who we got?
Raphael in the Bronx.
Yo, Raphael, what up?
What up, Jude? So my question, right, is pretty much like, I'm a truck driver, man. I'm 41. I'm trying to balance. I want a relationship and still do over the road shit. You know what I'm saying? And it's hard for me.
Yeah, how long are you gone for?
I mean, normally like 1.5 months, 2 months. Really, I'm out on the road all the time because I don't, right. You know, I ain't got a girl or nothing.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, but if you did get a girl, you'd be gone for 1.5 months, home for like 2 weeks, and then gone for another 1.5 months.
Nah. It'll be different, though. You know what I'm saying? I'll probably come home once a month or something for a couple of days here and there. And then, you know, I'm all over the country, so I'll stop. It's the fact that it's hard. It's hard to even begin something, especially when they know you got money. Forget about it. I got an ATM all over my fucking forehead.
Yeah, and it's like, it's one of those deals. It's like you got to find an independent woman that you can trust, that's okay with you being gone. But also, like, you might not like, some dudes like it and other dudes don't. Like, have you talked to other
OTR chicks. Yeah, I've smashed a few of them, but
have you talked to any of the dudes, like, with families and asked them how they like it? You know what I mean? Like, shit, you might, like...
I mean, a lot of them are miserable.
That's what I'm saying. So, like, perhaps you would want to, like, rethink, just drive locally and get a fucking girl, because... That's what I get a lot from a lot of these dudes that are doing like the long distance, gone for a long time trucking, is like, man, they miss their family. They want to be around their family, and they're hyped when they get to go home to them. Also, it's like, yo, dog, like, man, shit, bro, you got to really be able to trust somebody if you're going to be gone for a month and a half. You know what I mean? Like, shit.
That's another problem too, you know? And then you have, it's with me, it's like, do I trust her, you know, while I'm on the road? And it's so much temptation for us out here too, but
yeah.
I don't know. I'm caught in the crosshair. I'm like, I want a relationship, and then I don't want one, because, you know what I mean? It's a lot of pros and cons to it.
There is. I don't know, man. Like, I'm getting older. I'm 43, so I'm 2 years older than you. And like I said, bro, like, I just looked around, like, I was making money, just, but I didn't have nobody to call if something good happened or bad happened, you know, like, you just don't have that partner.
I could definitely dig that one.
You know what I mean? Like, you know that feeling, right? Yeah. It's like something happens, you got no one to call, you just sitting there with it by yourself. It sucks.
Yeah, I was in a relationship, but it's just, I don't know. It's not that I expect too much out of a woman. It's just I don't like a weak broad. I hate a weak woman. Like, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And I was in a relationship for 2 years. She was a truck driver. We got a spot in Springfield, Missouri, and kind of, you know, she was just too weak for me. I need a stronger woman. You know what I mean? Somebody who's gonna fight for their own life. If that right. makes sense. She had got sick, and I held it down, and, you know.
You don't want to like be saving chicks. It's hard. You don't want to save chicks. You want them to fucking be a strong, independent woman that can add to it. Not needy and shit. You know what I mean? Like fucking.
Yeah, man, that shit is crazy.
Bro, I honestly like it, if you. I would really look at fucking settling down somewhere and then settling down and kind of switching jobs because you've picked a career that is really hard to fucking do a family with. Like I said, I'm not the dude to talk to. Talk to other truckers out there and ask them how it works, if they like it, what they got to do to make it work, you know, shit like that. And if you're hearing more cons and pros, then maybe you should be like, all right, man, let me switch up shit. Because, like, bro.
I definitely get it.
You know, it's just like, money's cool, but, like, there's only so many hookers you can buy. There's only so many pairs of shoes you can own. You know what I mean? Like, there's only so, like, the fuck you gonna, you know. If you don't got somebody,
if you ain't got somebody, yeah. I got one more thing to say, Jude. Back in the day, you ain't shit on me, but that was your job. But you shit on me on the Jenny Jones show. I had an all yellow Coogee Charlie Brown outfit on. Back this was a long time ago, I had the all yellow. It was an all yellow Coogee Charlie Brown get up. And one more thing, I only got XM Radio to fuck with your show, bro. That's it. Like I've been fucking with your show for so long. And I appreciate the advice, though, man.
Yeah, no doubt, man. Yeah. Keep your head up and keep grinding. I don't even remember, like, that was Jenny Jones, man. I don't even remember Blazing Cats. There's so many fucking shows. I was, like, by the time they canceled it, I was so happy. I was like, I'm running out of shit to say because I wouldn't repeat a joke. 888-742-3345.
Got Maya in Cleveland.
Maya in Cleveland.
Maya. Yes.
What's going on with you? What seems to be the problem?
The problem is, like, I just want to know, how long do you take, like, somebody not texting you back until, like, you cut them off?
How many times have you texted this, like, this is your man or some shit, or this is somebody you fuck with? Or
I mean, like you're talking to him. Yeah. Like, I talk to him, like, pretty heavy or whatever. But, like, he doesn't text back in, like, a reasonable time. And it's kind of irritating. And, like, I've already told him, like, you know.
What are you texting him about? And how long does it take him to text you back? Give me, like,
you know, just, like, normal conversation. Like, good morning, like, hey, or something. He'll take, like, a long time to text back. I'm like, he's, I don't know.
I don't know. You sound needy.
Oh, I sound needy. Oh my God, I sound needy. I swear I'm not needy. Like,
you're texting good morning. Like,
24 hours to text back.
I understand that, but like, yeah, I feel you. But like, yeah, but like, you know, of course, it shouldn't take him 24 hours. How about you don't text him fucking. How about you don't text him frivolous shit and then see if his text back rate is better. Like, good morning, good night. Like, fucking.
I don't text good night.
All right, fine. But it'd be one thing is like, but what I'm saying, it'd be one thing if it was like, hey, did you want to get up on Thursday? And you hit him on Monday with that shit. Hey, did you want to get up on Thursday? And he doesn't hit you back till fucking Wednesday. You know what I mean? Like that, and that's a regular thing.
Like that, you feel me? Like, I said that was an example.
Well, my example was better than your example. Your example was like, good morning.
Okay, maybe your example was better. My bad, bro.
I'm just fucking with you. But like, yo, but the thing is I asked a specific question and you just said good morning. You see the difference? That's all I'm saying. Like, text some shit. Okay. Like, some motherfuckers just aren't texty. But
yeah,
it sounds to me like he's a bit distant and maybe he's not the one for you. You know what I mean? Like, maybe he's not the guy for you, especially if you're feeling disrespected. by the shit and you've brought it up to him and he continues to behave in that way. Even if, like, yeah. he could just be like, look, I'm not going to be texting you good morning. Like, that would have been the right answer. You know what I mean? Like, look, I'm not going to text you good morning. Like, I'm busy. I'm busy in the fucking morning to be starting these text conversations. Just know that I want you to have a good morning in your heart. Like, just know that. Even if you don't get that text, that's what I would have said. I wouldn't have been like, yeah, okay. And then not text you back. So even that right. It sounds to me like his communication skills are a bit fucking off. It makes you feel insecure. And then that makes you text even more. And then he texts back. Then it makes him not text you back. And it's just, the cycle is awful. So why don't you pull back on your text and see how that goes. And if you're still feeling disrespected, then don't be with somebody that you feel is disrespecting you.
Right.
Because you deserve respect.
Thank you.
You got it. Bye. Yeah. I don't do good mornings.
Yeah, I'm not surprised. There's nothing wrong with that. It's nice. It shows you care.
No, like, how did people, can you imagine, like, before the text and shit, like, if I had to call my girl every morning and tell her good morning, like, if we weren't, like, well, it's ridiculous.
Well, that's an investment.
I'm talking about, is fucking texting. Like, texting's an investment.
Are you sitting there scrolling through Instagram? Just send her a little text.
Because then it's never just one text back. No, and then this and then that. And now you're having a whole fucking conversation. It's like, shit, man, I got to get up. I got to shave. I got to shit, shower, shave. Fucking.
Now you're clicking links.
Yeah, exactly. Look at this fucking, look at this thing I found. I'm like, oh my God. Now it's like I'm talking to a 4-year-old. Like, look at this. Da, da, da. It's like, I don't want that. So I can see that. But him not, like, hitting her back, even, like, I don't know, like, if him not hitting her back about, like, plans and shit like that, that's a bit disrespectful. Even I don't know, let me check, is better than fucking silence. If I ask a question and, like, that motherfucker, someone doesn't hit me back for fucking 2 days, I'm like, what the fuck? Like, yeah, I asked you that on Monday. It is now fucking Thursday, dude. I already made other plans. Like, fuck you. That wouldn't last long. All right, what else?
Julian in Massachusetts.
Julian.
Yo.
What up, man?
How's it going, dude? Hey, I've been doing heroin now for a little while, and I've been going to the methadone clinic to try to clean up. So I started messing around a little bit for the past couple of months, and I've had this girl for 10 years, and she's really good to me and takes care of me, and I don't know if I should tell her or what I should do.
Tell her what? That you've been on heroin for a long time and now you're on methadone? Well,
She knows I go to the methadone clinic and she knows I've been being clean, but the past month I've been screwing around.
Oh, you mean cheating on her?
No, I'm not cheating on her. I'm doing dope again. And I
Oh, you relapsed.
Yes.
Unless you want a kick, tell her. If you don't want a kick, you better keep that shit to your fucking self. And, like, I would even try kicking silently. You know what I mean? Like, she probably knows, dude. Like,
that's what I was trying to do for a couple of days, but it's hard to hide that, you know? You can't.
Yeah,
eat.
I know, with the sickness and shit. But, like, then fucking come clean. But, like, yo, bro,
I mean,
like,
she already thought I had corona last week when I was trying to kick.
Yeah, and then you fucking end up. So you're still on dope and. You're on dope and methadone or just dope?
Yeah. Yeah, both now.
Ugh.
I'm still going, man, to the clinic.
All right, man. Like, I don't know, bro. Like, you got to be careful with that methadone. If the doctor is good, it can really work. If the doctor is a piece of shit, they can string you along on that shit forever. So.
Yeah, no, careful. I know.
Be careful with that methadone. You need to kick, bro. Like, come on, bro.
All right, man. I'll try. I'm trying.
Yeah. Well, ain't no trying, it's doing. It's your choice. Like, you got to choose to, you got to choose to kick.
Yeah.
Or stay on that dope, you know what I mean? But, like, you might lose everything. And that might.
Yeah, I don't want to do that.
All right, then. Well, you know what you got to, you know what you're risking, so.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm sure your chick's tired of you being addicted to heroin, right?
Well, she doesn't know I'm using it anymore. That's what I'm saying. She just thinks I'm going to the clinic and getting clean.
I understand, but like, okay, all right. So you look, man, relapsing after a couple years, man, like that fucking shit happens. So like, just
she's a goody two-shoe though.
All right.
It's like a shocking thing for her, you know. It's not like, you know.
All right, what if you said you're going to, like, go on a fucking vacation with your fucking homies or some shit and just went to somewhere else and kicked?
Oh, wait, nah, she's not. I don't think she'd go for that as far as,
I'm just trying to find ways where you can silently kick. If she can't accept you for what the fuck you are, then fuck it. But, like, I think she will.
All right, man. All right.
Keep your head up, man. Don't beat yourself up too bad over this shit. But, like, wait, you've been on methadone for 2 years?
Yeah, for about 2 years now, and I haven't used
that's a shitty doctor, dude. Like, that's a fucking shitty doctor.
Well, I started at 120 milligrams, and I'm down to 32 right now.
All right. What, has he got you on the fucking 7-year plan to fucking kick? Why don't you boss up like an old school dope fiend and just fucking puke your guts out and fucking go have full of sweats and shit like that and just kick without fucking the help of methadone? Pussy.
Shit sucks, man.
Yeah.
This shit fucking sucks.
You're on a leash right now.
Yeah,
you're on a fucking 2-year leash.
Yeah.
All right, man, bye. You get your shit together.
Bro. Thanks, man.
No doubt, man. Get your shit tighten it up, man. Tighten it the fuck up on everything. Doc's got him on a 2-year plan.
Yeah, he's kind of slow rolling that.
Fucking, that dude bought a Lambo off his ass. Fucking every time he visits. Cha-ching, cha-ching, cha-ching.
You know, he told me off air, he was actually high at that moment, which I don't know if he told you on the air, but he was high on heroin when we were talking. I figured they'd be like comatose, but you can function on heroin. Yeah, I didn't know.
No. Yeah, I got tons of junkie homies. Like, just fucking do their shit. The worst is like a lot of cats need that shit to be able to work. You know what I mean? Or else they're fucking sick as hell.
Yeah,
fucking, you know, and it sounds like that's the point that he's at. All right, 888-742-3345. Let's play a song and come on back. It is All Out Show. What would you do? I'm here to fucking save your life.
You're listening to the All Out Show with you.
Yo, it is the All Out Show. How you doing there? It's What Would You Do? I'm here to save your life. I'm here to help you. Call up right now. Who do we got?
Got Danielle out of New York.
Hey, Danielle, what's your problem?
Hey, dude. All right, so I've been with my husband for 3 years now. He's messed up in the past, but I found a text from a woman that said, "So sexy," and he stored it as a man's name, and the entire thread was deleted. So what do I do? It was very confusing that he deleted the thread.
Oh, he's cheating on you. You already know that, so.
Well, I mean, we live together.
Well, you got to decide what you want to do. You want to decide. You got to decide whether you want to make it work or fucking. But he's clearly cheating on you, and he's probably been cheating on you, and he's thoughtful about it. Thoughtful enough to fucking store her name as a man in case
right.
You discovered the phone and the thread's deleted. So
okay.
you got yourself, you married a sneaky bastard.
I did.
I don't know if you can trust this one. I don't know if
this, see, but we this is, we live together. We are together 24/7. So
I don't know.
I don't know.
Either way, he's fucking with if he ain't physically cheating, he's emotionally cheating.
Yes.
He's not
honest. We have a kid together.
Yeah. You got a kid.
I mean,
together.
What do I do? Right.
I don't know, man. I don't know. You got to work. You got to sit down. I'm not going to tell you to leave him, and I'm not going to tell you to stay with him. It's like, you got to figure it out. But just like, and you said he's cheated before, and now you caught him cheating
again. Not cheated, but he goes on these apps, and he has his little way with these girls when he knows that his queen is at home. But he does these things, and it's like, what are you doing, man? You know? Why are you going on these apps? Why are you talking to these girls?
How do you know he didn't cheat?
I don't.
What the fuck do you think them apps are for?
To meet people, to cheat.
All right.
I know.
Okay. You're like living in perpetual denial. And I guess you have to in order to fucking blow him at night. But, he's definitely, come on. Let's quit lying to ourselves and move forward from there.
I mean, he tells me the whole spiel, you know, I love you, I love this, I love that, I love our family, and then he goes on these apps and he does this bullshit.
Both can be true. He might just be a selfish motherfucker, you know what I'm saying? But, like, you need to address this with him and go from there.
Mm-hmm.
And figure out what you're going to do.
Yeah, I'm just looking for
that he cheated. You literally, it took me fucking, like, we literally had to go through all these questions just to, this motherfucker has cheated on you, man.
Well, thank you for telling me, because I guess I'm clueless.
Yeah, you are. But you're clueless on purpose, because you can't deal with the fucking truth of the matter, the facts. The fact of the matter is he cheated on your ass. Yeah, you're fucking you're in perpetual denial. And he keeps doing that shit.
Well, thank you. Yeah, I'm
welcome.
Getting played. Thank you.
Yeah. Yeah. You said it. I'm glad you got there. Now it's like, can he change? I don't know. I mean, you wouldn't even fucking come. You wouldn't even, like, tell yourself the truth. So, like,
I mean, it's the question, is he going to change? Is he going to change? Is he going to change?
Yeah, that is the question. So, yeah. So there you go. All right, let's keep this shit moving. 888-742-3345. 888-742-3345.
Got Terrell in St. Paul, Minnesota.
Terrell.
Hello, how you doing?
Fucking awesome. What's your problem?
Man, my problem is I have a wife who's 33. I'm 45. She's 5 months pregnant. She keeps telling me that every time we get in an argument, I'm going to get rid of the baby. I'll have an abortion, stuff like that. Man, I'm so far gone with this shit.
That's really fucking telling that she would use, she'd use the child as leverage against you. So it sounds to me like you came in the wrong woman, dude. Like, what a fucking cunt.
I'm just gonna say this. She's been there for me from the bottom to the top, like from my 15 years in prison, you know, getting out, the lawsuit, all that. She's been there through everything, and like, I've been with her for 10 years, you know, so I'm 10 years older than she is. So I really love this woman, and I really wanted this to work out. You know what I mean? But fuck.
All right. Well, I mean, look, she's 5 months pregnant. I mean, like, that's a fucking kidding, you know what I mean? Like, that's like a fucking that's not like a just a nothing, man. That's a, she's got the baby bump and everything, you know, like you need to sit her down when you guys aren't arguing, and you need to say, look, you when you and I are arguing, as mad as you get, you can't use that child against me. Like, you can't. it's hurtful to me and it's hurtful to us ultimately, and we both want to be together, but that's not the way, that's not going to work. You need to sit her down and try to explain that to her. Also, like, look, man, she's pregnant, so she got the crazy ass hormones, but just know moving forward, like, she's going to use, she's the type of person that is going to use the child as leverage against you if shit gets weird. Just know that. So be prepared for that.
Oh, I already know. And, you know, my thing is, like, the lawsuit I just won, you know, and we're not, like a major play into this. Like, she's not sticking around for the money, you know. And when she's been there with me when I didn't have shit, you know. Yeah. And then, you know, fell from the top back to the bottom, you know, going to prison, you know. All that money went down the drain, you know what I mean? But now I'm back on top again. You know what I mean? Like, the money's not an issue, you know, with her.
Yeah.
Like, because she's not after the money.
I didn't say she was, but, like, her using the child as leverage is fucking fucked up. So she, yeah. That's something.
Oh, absolutely.
That's a behavior she needs to curb. And you can even explain to her, be like, that's like you saying that you're going to fucking kill something that you and I both made out of anger for me is really hurtful. You know, just be all the way real with her. Like, keep that shit 100. Be like that. Yo, man, like, that's something that I don't take lightly. You know?
I ain't feeling that shit.
Yeah.
I mean, she already knows that I had a daughter that passed away in my arms at birth. You know what I mean? So, like, this is my only, this child that she's having now would be my only living child.
Yeah, man. Like, all right. So, yeah, when you're not arguing, you need to talk to her about that. Be like, you can't fucking say that to me. Like, there's just certain things that we can't bring into that's going to be bad for us ultimately. And, like, you telling me that you're going to abort our child is fucking awful. You know what I mean? Like,
right.
Yep. Even if you feel that way, like, keep it to yourself, because it's just something awful to say. And especially now, the motherfucker probably has like fingers and toes and shit. Like, dog, just not cool.
Yeah, yo. You know, and I mean, she loves me. Don't get me wrong. You know, the woman loves me. It's just that when we get into it, she likes to bring up my child. You know,
I get it. I understand. I like, but that, like, that's why you got to talk to her about it when you guys aren't fucking fighting. Yep. And see if try to get that through her fucking head so she doesn't keep exhibiting that behavior. That being said, she may be the type of person that keeps exhibiting that behavior. So you got yourself a fucking maniac on your hands. Congratulations. She might not be after the money, but she's after your kid's life. She's after half of you. So that's even worse than being after the money. You try to squash that shit, and hopefully she understands. And other thing too is like, right now it's like she's fucking going on, like, pregnant chicks are fucking got all the hormones bouncing around on them and shit. So like, try when you're dealing with her, try to keep that in mind. Like, give her a bit of leeway, you know. Don't take shit too personal to the point where it gets to the point where she's saying fuck shit like that.
Right.
You see, you dig what I'm saying?
Like, yep.
All right.
I appreciate you guys, man.
Keep your head up and congrats on the lawsuit and the baby. She ain't gonna kill the baby, but it's still not cool to say, man. Fucking.
It's a little twisted. That's a little twisted.
Yeah. And this is shit you don't find out until you fucking get them pregnant. You know what I mean? Like, fucking, that's fucking out cold. 888-742-3345. 888-742-3345.
Got Brian in Pittsburgh.
Brian.
What's going on? So, a mutual friend that's been recently hanging around, she's throwing off vibes, flirtatious vibes, sometimes, sometimes not, texting me crazy, like, hours of the night, like, what's going on, what you doing? I just don't know.
Do you got a girl?
She's like, see, no, I don't.
Oh.
I've been single for 2 years. She throws off vibes like she's trying to be like cool friends. And then she's throwing off like flirtatious vibes. We've been hanging out recently. I just don't know if I should go in and shoot my shot or what's the deal.
I would shoot my shot.
Because
it's like this. Either she's down, like if you feel like she's shooting you fucking vibes, you know what I mean? She's throwing you a vibe. Either she's down, and that's dope, or she's like some fucking like thirst trap that's using you for attention. Right. So fuck her. Either it'll be cool, like if she's continually throwing you vibes and then you fucking, I would react to the vibe and be like, yo, what up, da da da, and she's like, what are you talking about? You don't need her as a friend, fuck her.
Right. No, like the first time I actually met her, she like knew all about me, and I only have heard her name a few times, and like I walk in the bar and the first thing she says is, wow, you look good, because I've been going to the gym, whatever, losing weight, and she noticed that like right off the rip, and she's like, oh, you look so good, and like, you know, I'm just shooting right back to her. But
yeah, bro, like what do you need, a fucking like,
and bro, like that's a fog not horn
or some
you.
Shit like that, just fucking holler at her, dog.
In there, but I don't know either,
but like sounds to me like she likes you, so fucking go for it. All right, who's next?
KB in Tampa.
KB, what up, man?
Yo, quick question.
All right, go ahead.
So me and my girl are trying to figure out how to go about getting a threesome going. We've been on apps and shit, but nothing's been, you know, this is a big plan. Plan, hardcore.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I don't know, like, in the right now, but you're down in Tampa, right?
Yo. Yeah.
All right. So, like, I don't know. I would go out to a bar or some shit like that. Go to a fucking a lesbian club and see if there's another chick that's down. That's what I would do.
True. I mean, we've been out and shit like that too. And I mean, we've seen a couple of females, but you know, it's kind of hard to tell who is who and shit like that. And
what does that mean?
If they swing that way. Like if they swing my way,
it's both of y'all are girls, right?
Yes.
Or are you a dude? Okay, all right. Just want to make sure because KD could be anything, but you sound like a girl. All right. So you're a woman.
Yes, I am.
All right. So it's one of those things where like you got to put yourself out there. Like you got to be like, hey, what's up? You know, what do you want to come to the? You want to come hang out with us later? Later tonight, you know, like that kind of, you're insinuating something might happen, you know, and go from there. Like just kind of, you got to talk to people and be ready for rejection too, also. Like,
yeah, and I'm cool with rejection, you know.
Yeah,
you know, that's what builds character.
Exactly. And I don't think any chick I haven't like, I think a lot of chicks would be flattered if you try to pick them up. You know what I mean?
Like, right.
Even if they weren't into it, they probably take it as a compliment anyway. So.
True.
So just right. Like just go, and whoever's got the best mouthpiece, or between you and your girl, whoever has the best game, let them run that shit, and then. You know, then go from there.
All right, bet. Appreciate it.
Yeah, good luck. And if it does happen, call up and let us know how it goes. 888-742-3345. 888-742-3345.
Got Nigel over in Oakland.
Nigel in the Bay.
How you doing, dude?
Man, you got it. What's your problem?
Man, I've been having some serious stress issues, and I'm not sure how to deal with them. I got a difficult job I've had for about 8 months.
Yeah.
And for some reason, I've been stressing out to the point I had to go to the hospital.
Damn.
it's a project manager position where they kind of combine that with an install manager. So I go around, measure windows, and then I deal with all the clients and the crews, you know, once the job is sold. And
yeah,
for some reason, man, I'm having really bad anxieties. I also have another issue that it's probably affecting it. I got a son who's just turned 30, and he's been in jail for 6 years fighting a murder case. Mm. And he's bipolar, so he hasn't made it to court. He keeps having competency hearings, and I think that's also probably some of my stress level.
Yeah.
But
yeah,
I'm not sure what to do, man.
It sounds to me like
I've been kind of a macho guy, and I don't really like the idea of seeing a therapist. And
have you thought of if you got to go to the fucking hospital, there's nothing wrong with fucking, like, that's you trying to get help right there. So it sounds to me like you need somebody just to at least vent to, you know what I mean? Just to get shit off your chest. That's a lot to carry around with you. You know, your son's locked up with the murder case, and he's got mental issues, and you just got promoted, so you got all these new things riding on your back that you're not used to. You'll get used to your job. It won't be as stressful. That's what a lot of motherfuckers don't realize is, like, you know, like, when they see the manager or the fucking owner, all they see is the money that they make. They don't know that, they don't understand that you go home, you take that job home with you, and you're like working it all the fucking time, like, and it grinds on you. They don't understand the grind. Like, all they see is like the rewards. They don't understand the grind that you're going through. Like, you're worrying about you got to keep a whole crew in line and make sure everything's good and the clients are good. Like, you got a whole lot more on your plate. Now, it's going to be, and it's going to continue to be stressful, but you'll get used to it. You will get used to it. But for now, like, you need to talk to somebody and then come up with some shit. Like, I don't know if it's exercising or fucking meditating or some shit like that.
Because I've been meaning to find a bicycle and get a little exercise, because I used to, you know, lately I've been just driving around doing my job and not getting any exercise and not eating well or drinking water. So I know there's some small things I can do that may help a bit.
Yeah, that's also a reflection of, yeah. Like for instance, I was the same when I was dealing with the house, like trying to fix the house up. Like, the only shit's open is, like, everything's closed, so the only shit's open is McDonald's. And like, I looked at my car and I just like looked down. I'm fucking stressed the fuck out. I'm eating like shit. There's empty McDonald's bags all over my fucking shit. It was just like, I felt like a piece of shit. So like, I really can relate to you on tackling something new and feeling stressful. But like, yeah, control, like, get your diet under control, get your exercise going, go holler at somebody. If that doesn't work, then go holler at somebody, you know, go from there. I'm trying to find a sensory deprivation tank so I can meditate in that bitch, because I can't meditate on my own. Like, this shit forces you to meditate. So like, even me, I'm trying to find things that help me deal with the continuous fucking stress of living. Life is stressful, bro.
Yeah.
You know, life is stressful, and you got a lot on your plate. So just know that. Give yourself a break too.
All right, man. I really appreciate it, man. I love your show, and I love the music you play. I'm always surprised when I hear stuff like RBL Posse, all the bass shit that I grew up on. When you play that, I'm like, how does he even know what that is? How did you even hear that out there?
We're cousins. You don't understand. We played all that fucking mob music, Bay Area shit. We played all that shit. We're fucking cousins.
That's what I hear. Anyway, yeah, man, I love your show, and I appreciate your advice, bro.
Yeah, and keep your head up and... keep your head up and just know that, like, it's what you're going through is stressful. So like, you're not abnormal. There's nothing wrong with you. You're just going through some stressful ass shit. So you just need to take care of it. 888-742-3345.
Phil in Chicago.
Phil in the Shy.
Hey Jude, how do I tell a girl with possibly the best sex I've ever had that her breath is funky?
I would tell her to be like, what's it smell like? Is it like...
Man, it's indescribable. Seriously, it is, man. And and she's always trying to be affectionate and kiss, and I come up with excuses to not be... Well, to not kiss, basically, at all.
So, I think it's one of those deals where you need to, like... I'd brush my teeth in front of her and give her a toothbrush and be like, "Hey, brush your teeth too," and see if that shit helps. Honestly,
I get notices from my dentist. They'll call me when I have an appointment coming up, when it gets close to my appointment day, so I don't miss it. And that has happened on more than one occasion where I'm like, well, you know, it's time for me to get my annual cleaning. Every 6 months I get a cleaning. And I hinted to her, like, when are you going to the dentist? I even hinted to her that your son is four. It's time for him to get a checkup. We need for him to go to the dentist. To not just,
you know what? Like, here's the crazy shit is I had a similar problem with a woman, and she had like a sandwich just filled with fucking onions. You know, I think it was like a shawarma. She like ate some fucking chicken shawarma sandwich, and they just dump onions in that shit. And she came through and she had the fucking onion breath. And I was like, yo, you got to brush your teeth. Like, you got onion breath.
This is more so of a rotten tooth or something. I really don't know.
That's the thing. It's like, if you know, like, you need to get to the bottom of it first. Like, see if a brushing solves the problem. If that brushing doesn't solve the problem, I'll fucking peace out, because like, that's just bad hygiene, man. That's fucking disgusting.
You know how some people use AIM, Colgate, or something like that? I see Sensodyne. She's 30. For sensitive teeth.
Yeah, look, I'm gonna be real with you. I use the same shit because I brush my teeth too hard and it fucked with my gums up. So I've got to use like the fucking I got to use the old man fucking toothpaste too. So I'm not gonna judge too harshly. But my breath doesn't smell like a swamp.
Right.
Could be diet, could be anything, man. But I would kiss her after she brushed her teeth and see if it stinks afterwards. Like, I don't know, man. Like,
after 9 months, you can just walk away.
Yeah, I could. I don't know. I could just be like, look, our chemistry is off, da da da, blah blah blah. And if she presses you, just be like, your breath is awful.
Don't do that.
I don't think I could do that, man. Like, I will come up with some type of excuse, man.
You're like,
come on,
have
Jude.
you ever smelled a dead rat in a wall? Like, right. Yeah. Be like, that's your breath, and I can't deal with that anymore.
I would really joke with her and say, damn, how can you have morning breath and it's 9 o'clock at night? I joke. But seriously, I'm telling the truth at the same time. I'm telling
the fact that she's
truth.
Not even picking
PM.
Up on that shit, bro. I don't know, man. Like, if you can't deal with her smell, I would fucking, I'd get the fuck going.
Bounce.
So that's kind of what I would do. That's how I
Thanks,
would do
bro.
It.
Thanks, bro. I appreciate it.
Yeah. I mean, honestly, shit, man. Fuck. Yeesh.
What's wrong with Sensodyne? Is that for people like dentures or something? Or what's the...
I don't know. I had one of them motherfuckers that, like, it's just me and fucking 80-year-old people buy. Fucking whatever. Some shit for fucking helping with your fucking teeth. Taking it easy on your teeth.
God. They're like, you're supposed to go really soft and fucking circles. I'm like,
I brush them wrong or some shit. I don't know. This guy's... good pussy. Isn't that the fucking... It's like God just wants to fuck with you. It's like, here's some bomb pussy and the worst breath ever. I can't take bad smells, so I'm a smell dude. Like, if you smell fucked up. And the other thing too is like, when you're like real good looking, people don't tell you the truth. No, don't tell you your breath stinks or some shit like that. You can just go through life with stinking ass breath and somebody will put up with it. She's had a bunch of people put up with bad breath for a long time because she's cute. 888-742-3345.
Rachel in Louisville, Kentucky.
Louisville.
Hey, I've been dating a guy for a year and 4 months, and he doesn't want me to post pictures or anything on social media. Like, do you think he's cheating? Like, what should I do?
He doesn't want you to post pictures of him or...
Us.
Oh, y'all together?
Him, us, yes. We've been together for a year and 4 months.
What about you?
I met all his kids.
You met all of his kids? Have you ever asked him why he does... Have you? What's his reason?
At first, it was... His reason was because he was... Didn't want his baby mama to trip because she's psycho. And then she, like, started... She got engaged, and that was, like, he was fine, and that was over. And then all of a sudden, like, I asked him recently, and he's like, no excuse. He's just, like, a private person. He said, why do we have to... Why does everybody not got to know what we doing? He was like, we can be together and not have everybody in our freaking business.
Is there any other things that make you think he's cheating or just that?
I mean, he did cheat before. Like, he keeps saying no, but the girl actually hit me up on Facebook and showed me, like, all kinds of things. And she was like, I just wanted you to know. And he denies it, but...
Oh, when he's so he's, oh, he's, yeah. he's smart. Deny.
And I tell him, like, if you with somebody else, like, go with somebody else. Like, just leave me alone.
You're like, if you can't put up pictures of you and him, then that means you're the other woman.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking. But I'm like, I went and I spent because the baby mama, they were living together because he was incarcerated, and then that was the home that he had put where he had to go. So that's where probation. I don't know what it is, but
parole.
That's his house. So yeah. Now she's there. I mean, she's gone and she moved out with her dude, and I actually spent like 3 days over there, and I just don't know. Like, it's not clicking to me. Like, I want to trust him. He said he made a mistake back then. You know, that was the beginning of our relationship. But, like,
that's the Facebook girl he made a mistake with, or that was a different girl?
No, it's a different girl.
Jesus Christ. This guy's cheating. He's a perpetual.
No, that was the Facebook girl.
Okay.
That's the girl that hit me up on Facebook. Yeah.
But you said he's never admitted to it.
Yeah, he says she's lying. He was like, that's the girl that I fucked with when I first got out of prison, and she's just a fucking psycho. And
every girl's a psycho that he deals with, huh?
Yeah.
Wow, he's really bad at reading characters.
I asked her for some proof myself, and she said she was going to send it over or whatever, and she never did. And then I seen a text that she sent to him and told him talking about I told you I was going to get Raquel, never to speak to you again.
Man, I don't know. This
it's just weird.
It just sounds like all this drama, dude. Like, what the fuck?
That's what I'm saying. And I'm just like...
So, do you want that?
No, I don't. It's just like, I've been with him so long, and I've, like, invested, like, my time, I feel like. Because before him...
I know, but, can't throw good money after bad just because, like, a year ain't that long.
Yeah, I know. And the thing about it is, like, I was married, and my husband cheated, and he left me. And this was the guy that he was there for me. He actually helped me pick myself back up. I was, like, I had got overweight, and I ended up losing, I went from... 264 pounds to 160. And, like, he's the one that helped me. He's the one that, helped me bring myself back to me.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. All right, but that doesn't, that still doesn't mean he's not cheating on you, or that he, or he, it doesn't mean that he's faithful. I can't tell by the one thing. Like, I probably, you know, like, if I wasn't in the public eye, I wouldn't want to be online either. Does he have a Facebook page? Like,
yes,
does
he
post?
Has a Facebook page.
So he posts other places, but you know, like, all right, so.
He
He's
has
not
a Facebook
consistent.
And he has an Instagram. He really don't post on his stuff that much. He don't at all. He don't like taking pictures or nothing like that.
All right.
He posts his kids.
All right, so at least he's consistent, but that's weird. He's posting his fucking kids. I don't know, man. Like, you gotta figure out if he's cheating on you or not. I can't tell by what you've told me, but like, I think deep down you know what the real answer is. Like, I think deep down you know.
Yeah. It's like I feel it in my gut, so.
There you go.
And I keep trying telling him, like, I'm falling back. And every time I try, like, he, like, blows me up and, like, constantly, like, he's like.
Yeah, of course. Of course. Like, there is no fun. Like, yo, if you leave him, leave him. Don't answer the phone. Yeah. Don't be talking to him. Just be done with his ass. Because he'll claw his way back into your life. That's if you
I just don't get it, though. Like, if you want to be with other bitches, like, be with other bitches. Just leave me alone. Why do you want to have your cake and eat it, too? Like, what's up with that?
Because sometimes as men, we're insecure, and one woman's love isn't enough for us. Sometimes we just want to conquest. Other times we just don't respect the person we're with. There's a million and one different reasons why people cheat, but don't take it personal. Yeah. Honestly, don't take it personal. Okay. It's not about you. It's about him and his character.
Okay.
He'd be doing it to any other chick too, even if it was fucking the most beautiful girl in the world. Doesn't matter, motherfuckers. If it's in them to cheat, they're gonna cheat. She can be the baddest chick. Don't matter. All right, I think that's it.
Can we do one more? This one's
all right. Fine.
Pretty cut and dry.
Fine. All right. Cool.
In my mind. All right, Kylie in Muncie, Indiana.
Kylie, you better thank John because I was done. Yo.
Hey, yes, sir. I got a question, man. Look, all right, look. I'm dark skinned. I'm a girl, too, at that. I'm dark skinned, you know what I'm saying? Had a little bad, little light skin over the summertime. But word around town is she on that shit. She, you know what I'm saying? Pop pills, all that shit. So should I fuck with her? Or should I just, like, cause, you know, I don't pop them pills. I only smoke weed. So, like, I don't want that, you know, everybody be looking at me like, you fuck with the crackhead. Like, you know what I'm saying? So,
I mean, like,
damn, bro, she bad though. Like,
when you're hanging out with her, look at her eyes.
I noticed it. I seen it before when she owned the shit. So, I mean, so like, it happened one time. Maybe I can get her out of it. You never know.
I don't know. You're not going to save nobody. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
You know what you're signing up for. All right, so she's on them
bad,
pills.
Man.
Well, all right, just don't take her too serious.
And bars at that, yeah.
And she's on Xanax and fucking perks or fucking.
I think it's the bars and blue bars. Yeah, I don't know because I feel like you know what I'm saying, that shit could be fake for all I know. So I don't know. I don't know what you're doing. To be honest.
Well, it's probably much, yeah, like. So. It's, the shit going around right now is a lot of press Xanax, but if her eyes are
like she nodding off and shit, like
yeah, if her eyes are pinned, then that's dope or perks or some type of fucking opioid.
Yeah, bro. So I can't even fuck with her. Then that's what you're saying. Don't do it.
If you, I mean,
you know, so I don't know if she got some good pussy or not. My shit fake. So, I mean, like, you know what I'm saying? So,
you can have fun, but I wouldn't take her serious.
Yeah, should I be seen in public? That's the question. I don't want to be seen in public. This is a small city.
Yeah, nah, I wouldn't cuff her.
See,
nope.
Yeah.
I'd just go over there for some booty calls. Some booty calls. And keep in mind that, like, they're going to choose dope over you.
See, I don't think it's that bad, though. Like, you know what I'm saying?
Oh. All right, well, then.
Yeah, I mean, I don't know if it's social.
Dude, if she's got a fucking reputation and she's nodding off around you, it might be that bad.
Okay, you got me. Yeah, you got me.
You know what I mean? Like, the yeah. fact that
And she knows she's an alcoholic, too, so yeah, you got me.
Oh, and she's an alcoholic? Jesus fucking Christ.
I'm talking about waking up Seagram's vodka already.
Dude, what are you... Don't...
I mean, that's...
Looks aren't everything.
Get it up in there. It was a summertime fling, like, you feel me? Like,
yeah.
And then she fell for me, but, like, you know, I had something else on the side, so I was like, I don't know what to do, but, like, she bad, like, light skin, I'm dark skin, like black and ugly as ever, however, then bitches don't come type shit, like.
No, look, man, you gotta fucking, first off, you gotta like yourself, okay? And you deserve whatever fucking girl you pull, and stop calling yourself fucking ugly, all right? Like, because that's the only face you got, so you better look at it and find some beauty in that shit. And don't put up with some fucking drunk junkie because you don't think you're good enough, all right? Because you are.
I appreciate it, Jewel. You know, I know I'm up there. Appreciate it, man.
Yeah, for real. Like, god damn it. Like, fuck her. Like, I don't care how cute she is. Like, you want some bitch shaking because she didn't drink her trembling because she didn't drink her fucking Seagrams in the morning? Jesus Christ. That's worse than John.
Oh, he didn't even know what month he was. So I'm in a small ass city. Like, I'm 45 minutes away from Nap. So, I mean, like, you gotta get what you gotta get, low key. Like, you feel me? Like, there ain't too many.
Yeah, no, I understand. Like, it's slim pickings out there. I get it. But, like, man, you better off alone than dealing with that shit. Like, that's a lot of habits, man. Fucking pills, and fucking a drunk. Not just like fucking drinks too much at night. Like, waking up to fucking Seagram's. Nah, that's a lot, dude. That's a lot. Not worth it. All right, done. Settled. It's settled. How long you think she's gonna break it off or nah?
Probably in a couple weeks after a few more rounds with that lovely person, who's known around town as a crackhead. But dang.
And the ironical part is it's not crack at all. It's just pills and alcohol and fucking dope.
Oh yeah,
there it is.
I mean, I've hung out with ladies when we're at the bar and they're clearly on pills, and I didn't know that. And suddenly they put their heads down on the bar. I'm like, whoa, what's going on with you?
Yeah, fucking
chaos.
Chick nodding off on you and shit.
Good night.
The waking up to a drink one was that's a giant red flag. Like, that was awesome. Let me just drink this because I'll be. Like, I'll get sick. I'll go into a coma if I don't drink this fucking shit. The last thing you need, man. Fuck that.
I don't even do that. I mean, that's...
I know, dude.
That's the end of the road.
Lick.
I mean,
yeah, dog. That's fucking
gotta
rock
get straight.
Bottom.
Gotta get straight.
I don't care how good her pussy tastes. All right, man. Let's go.
You're listening to the All Out Show with you.
What's going on, people? You are listening to the All Out Show. I think I forgot to... Oh, god damn it. I was supposed to send everybody in the community the Valentine's mix. Did I send it to... Did I log in? What the fuck?
I didn't see it. I'm signed up.
Shit. I forgot to do it. And now I can't even get into my community account. Oh no. If you want to follow me on community, I can't get in my account. 213-205-3747 type pill mix, and I'll send you some shit as soon as I can get into the account. It's basically like a texting service that I can fucking send you shit that I can't access right now. So just be cool. I got you. Also follow All Out Show on everything, and One More Jude on Instagram. That's me, One More Jude. And then the All Out Show is all of the shit from the show. Boom. Bam. And one more, Jude.com, in case you want to grab some gear. And if you get some, take a picture of yourself in it. We'll post it on the All Out Show page. Everybody can marvel at how fucking cool you look in our awesome clothes. All proceeds go to Keenan and Johnny.
We appreciate it.
Yeah, no doubt. I get to pay taxes on this shit, but they get the shit. It's a bum deal for me, but what the fuck? What do I care? Taxes. All right, so I think I told you everything you need to know about how to follow us offline. I know you're like, okay, dude, you tell me that shit every day. And I'm gonna keep telling you. God damn it. Keep telling you. What do we got in the news today, John?
Got some dildo advice.
Advice about dildos. It's always good to please your lady. Sometimes bringing a dildo. Did I ever tell you about? Yeah, I think I had. There's some crystal that I bought that's supposed to help you sleep better.
Okay.
It doesn't. But the only shape that they sold it in was looked like a fucking dildo. So, and you're supposed to keep it under your pillow.
What?
But I didn't want to keep it under my pillow, so I kept it under my mattress. But every time, I'd fuck too hard and that shit would fall out, and it looked like I just had a crystal dildo. And I'd be like, no, it's to help you sleep. Be like, yeah, right. I forgot the kind of rock it is. It looks like snow. It's like all white. It looks like snow.
So let me get this. You honestly believe that this rock is going to help you sleep?
I believe in intention. I believe that there's power in intention.
Okay.
So if you put power into something, it has power. Does that make sense?
Sure.
If you say this is my lucky penny, and you hold on to that penny and you believe that it's your lucky penny, then it will become your lucky penny.
Hey, I've had hot women give me crystals and they tell me it has some sort of power. I'm like, fine with me. It's from you. I love it. Thanks for the rock.
Yeah. I know. I got a bunch of crystals that I got from as gifts that are supposed to do all these things. I forgot what the fuck they do. I just got them up. I got a whole thing of fucking crystals on my, I got a whole shelf full of crystals. Looks like a fucking museum or some shit. Geology museum. Yeah. Yeah, so it's less about the stone itself and more about the fucking intention behind it. That's anything. Even cats will be saying don't let this happen and that. I'll be like, yo, bro, why are you fucking speaking negative shit right now? Don't speak on the negative. I don't need that shit. I want positive vibes. I don't want no fucking worried ass vibes on my shit. Hell no. But that's just me. I don't try to speak on bad things. I don't want to burn bread on myself. All right. Here we go. Let's play some music and come back and talk about dildos. That was Crystal Talk.
You're listening to the All Out Show with you. And now, it's time for News from the Chin with John Z. Matthews.
I have a sexologist here.
Hey.
Gigi Engel. She is declaring that anyone can use a dildo.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Shit, anything can be a dildo. What are you talking about? If you're brave enough, you know what I mean?
Well, she's going to some of the myths here of using a dildo. If you're a straight guy, putting a dildo in your ass might mean you're gay. Wrong, she says. But
that sounds pretty gay to me, man.
You're definitely wandering in that forest.
Sounds pretty fucking gay. You throw a fucking dildo in your ass. A dildo is a fucking penis, right? So it's like having a dick in your ass.
Well, I've told you about these stories over the years about this whole prostate bliss, but I've no need to explore that.
That's the unfortunate part of being a man. We'll never know about the prostate bliss. Gay means happy, so maybe that's why gay motherfuckers so goddamn happy, because they got the prostate bliss.
Another myth she goes into here. If you use sex toys in your partner, it must mean you're not a real man who can satisfy someone with his penis. Wrong.
I kind of think that, but I also think that, like, you know, mix it up a bit. Have some fun. Like, I used that one sex toy that looked like the Mamma Mia thing that Emily, sex with Emily, gave me. And that shit was fun. It was fun watching her bust off of that shit. I was like, all right, cool. You still feel a part of it, you know what I mean?
Sure.
It'd be one thing if your girl didn't come with you and then you had to break out vibrators. But if your girl's coming with you and then you bring other things into the equation, then fuck it.
Well, she gets rather specific here, talking about inserting a dildo into the vagina or the anus during oral. You ever do that? Seems kind of complicated.
I've been, like, fucking a girl in her ass and putting a dildo in her pussy.
That's on the list. That is on the list.
There you go. Shit, I should start writing articles.
But this one device she has here, she suggests that you buy this spare parts hardware deuce harness, which costs nearly $200. But so it has a dildo on it, and it has a hole for your penis, so you can do the double penetration action.
Yeah, I would just do it my way. I'd save the money and just fucking do it my way. So it's like a fucking... It's basically like how they had those chin straps for the dudes, like with the dick on the chin. So when you eat them out, you can like fuck them with at the same time. Do you remember those chin strap
arm things? Oh, God, yeah.
Yeah, I don't know, man. I don't want to have to put on the strap on. I was talking to my homie about that, like, this dude had fucking surgery, and it fucked with his dick, and he ended up leaving his wife. And I was like, yo, it's probably because just like he felt like half of a man every time, you know, like he couldn't get his dick hard and shit, and just seeing her made him feel like half of a man. And like so just the idea of me having to fucking, can you imagine, like, you come home, she's like, I bought a strap-on for you to use on me because your dick can't get hard.
There's a hole, too, if you're up for it.
That's depressing as shit.
But you really have to see this thing now. It's in your text. I mean, right, I realize we're not talking gay here, but, boy, this looks pretty gay.
This is for the girl for the double penetration?
Look at the guy who's rocking this.
Oh, man.
I mean, it's a handsome man.
It's like a guy, yo, it's 140, it's 140, and it's got like this guy laying on a bed with a weird harness. I can't even fucking,
yeah, you get,
I can't even see the, yeah, I try to see the bigger picture, like, I can't even see, the dude looks gay that's even doing it. Yeah. They should have got a straighter looking, at least somebody with some hair on his chest. Like, this dude's like fucking fully shaved, arched eyebrows, wearing a weird strappy thing with a weird dick on it.
Doing lots of ab workouts.
And he's going, man, he's doing too much. He needs to chill.
Well, then they go into, of course, if you dig deep in this article, the whole idea of pegging, which again, that's kind of exotic.
Man, they're really pushing this pegging shit right now, dog. It's almost like they're trying to fucking feminize men.
She insists, not gay. And hey, it may not be, but boy, you're, again, traveling down that road. Which again is fine. That's fine.
Someone bend. Hey, look. This is the most fucking open-minded show. Like this show is open-minded as fuck. But like, I'm just saying, like, Pagan does look gay to the motherfucker. Like, looks gay to me.
Yeah, I remember.
Lucky for you, it's a chick doing it. You know what I mean? But like,
eh. Yeah, those listeners who were all about it with me, and I put the kibosh on that. But you know, Jason Ellis, he was. As you can imagine, encouraging me to do it. Like, come on, try it out. Like,
That's the thing. It's just like, look, man, we fuck with you a lot, but we can't have, I can't have my the producer of one of Sirius's top hip-hop shows, like one of the top hip-hop shows on Sirius getting fucked in the ass and not be gay. You know what I mean? Like,
I don't think you'd come back from
that. If you was gay, be just like, if you was like full blown gay, that'd be like one thing, but
he's out there living
just
life.
Getting pegged.
No.
Can't do that shit. No. Nah, bro. I didn't know this was gonna be, I didn't know this article was gonna be about just as fucking gay as it was. I thought this was gonna be a fucking like just about different ways to fuck chicks with dildos, and it's turned into like gay as hell. What else?
All right. But again, they are saying, hey, you know, if you're going down on her, maybe stick the dildo in her mouth. Well, she'd like that, but that's another option.
Stick it in her mouth, yeah. Or, you know, fingers or whatever. You can... A lot of shit, you can just use your... I say get your finger fucking game up. Get your finger game on, and then move on to dildos, too. Finger fucking is a lost art form.
Should you pack all the whole set? Do you have a little box there in the corner of your room now with the dildos and the toys, or no? Do they make the trip?
Man, I had a vibrator that Emily gave me that I had just found, and the battery life on that bitch sucked. So like we was using it for a second the other night, and then it fucking just, I was just like, damn dog, really?
Gotta keep that charged.
I charged that bitch like overnight. Like, this is for, like, it was 5 minutes of fucking vibrating. Are you kidding me? All right, come on.
Well,
all right, what else?
So, a lot of people try to stop drinking in January, dry January. Now, most people didn't make it.
Not this year.
They could not make it even 2 weeks without a sip of alcohol.
Dude, this has been like the most stressful fucking. We're on mandatory lockdown in half the fucking country. Like, stressful. People gonna drink.
Yeah.
And you're bored too. You're stuck inside. It's not even like you got fucking options to go socialize somewhere. Like, yeah, that makes total fucking sense. Gee, dry January didn't work out this year. Nope. I can't believe it.
The average American only lasted 10 days in their attempt before giving up altogether. Like, eh, so what?
I mean, shit, I started eating painkillers, man, like fucking every now and again. Not on a regular basis, but yeah. I wasn't doing it ever. And now it's just like, well, I ain't got shit to do, you know? Like, fuck it. Let me eat a Vicodin and fucking watch this movie or some shit.
It is possible to go too far. I had to pull it back a little bit. There were certain days I was coming in, I was looking in the mirror like, oh, dude, feels like your heart's going to stop.
Yeah, I feel you. especially like when I was back in LA, I was doing a lot of acid. You know, it was just like, yo, man, like, shit, son. But it's crazy. Yo, that's what happens, man. Like when you fucking confine somebody and like we got all this energy, I don't know what to do with this shit. I ain't going to go on a fucking nature hike. I'm going to do some drugs.
Now you got the skates. Go out on the pond.
Yeah, me and my special lady friend was supposed to go skating, and there was kids out there the whole fucking time. So we couldn't even go ice skating. And then when they finally left, it was dark, and she was like, I'm afraid to skate in the dark. And I was like, all right, fine, fair enough. Just chilled, so we didn't even go skating.
Well, I'm glad she's a safety first kind of person. You guys getting dunked in a freezing cold lake, that seems rather alarming at night.
That's not gonna happen. Yeah. It's fucking the ice is 7 inches thick over here, bro.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
Yeah, it's fucking seriously fucking. It's crazy over here, man.
You drive a car on that?
Crazy. I just shoveled fucking 10 inches of snow in my driveway. It's like a foot of snow I had to fucking shovel.
Well, it was tiring. You're not the only one. I've read about Texas. It's all going down in Texas. Big snow.
It's going down in Texas, too. How much did Texas get?
Oh, I mean, it's a real storm, but it's freezing, and the power's going out because they can't generate the power. It's a whole scene over there.
I mean, when you build a whole infrastructure not considering like freezing shit, yeah, it's easy to fucking disrupt something. Keep your head up, Texas. If you're listening on your fucking phone, we're gonna hold you down for the next 15 minutes, and then
you're on your own.
And then I'll be leaving. But I'm with you at heart.
Stay warm. So the AARP, they are warning their members about sending nudes because now a bunch of scammers are going after the olds, convincing them to take off their clothes, and then they instantly just like, oh, you're fucked. Give me $500.
Wait, what does AARP stand for?
Oh, that's the retirement operation, you know, for older people. Okay. Sorry about that.
Oh, AARP. So like the old people will get online and get tricked into like taking nudes, and then they'll be like, I'm gonna send this to your grandkids, basically.
Yeah, right, exactly. Don't fall for it. Yeah, but now the people who deal with the AARP are saying they've seen a spike in calls. Like, what do I do? What should I do?
What a good scam, though. That's
terrible. You guys had somebody do that to your mom? Sucks.
I didn't say it's fucking nice. I'm just saying it, like, as far as scams go, like, that's a good scam, dude. Like, I'll make your whole family, like, you're the patriarch of the family, and I'll make everybody look at you differently, you know? Like, you're fucked. Come. Yeah. That's fucked up.
Yes, it's pretty dark.
They're all alone. They're all alone in their house, just fucking around on the computer.
Yeah.
Someone hits them up. Like, oh, they get some attention and shit. You're some widower. Next thing you know, you're jerking off for the fucking on a webcam.
But people are falling for it.
Unfortunately for us, no one that old listens, but warn your grandparents not to fucking jerk off or finger themselves on camera for anybody, because they will be blackmailed.
But I mean, what's the real threat here? I mean, okay, let's say you sent your rock hard cock to some lady, and then suddenly she posted it somewhere. Would you be? I mean, I realize you and I are a little different, but would you care?
Imagine being like a granddad of like, and having like this family that you've raised, and they have their kids, and you're just like old gentle grandfather, and then
it's making me cringe.
Fucking, yeah, gets sent to their fucking 15-year-old grandkids email. Like, shit,
that's gotta
suck. The last thing I want to see is my fucking granddad's dick, honestly.
And of course, the older people, they don't really hide their privacy settings too well on Facebook, so it's pretty easy to figure out who to send shit to. So don't get caught up in that sewer.
Watch out, y'all.
But one final thing on this. They do warn you. Let's say you succumb to this, and then you send them $500, they're going to keep hitting you up for $500. You just got to...
Yeah, this is forever.
You're not going to make it go away.
It's a wrap. You're going to have to get ahead of it. Be like, look, Grandpa was naughty.
Just
bringing the family and shit. We're going to have a talk. Grandpa was naughty. You might get a picture.
So it looks like there are fewer opioid deaths occurring in areas with legal marijuana stores.
Hey, look at that.
They're not saying there's a direct causation, but I mean, they're just saying the data suggests that, yes, the more dispensaries you have, the less people are dying from doing opioids.
That makes sense. A lot of people use cannabis for pain, and they were like, that's my pops. He was on
I just lost you there. What was he on?
He was on pills. He was like on, they was giving him Vicodin or some shit. and he was doing those for like leg pain, and then my cousin got him off of that and on the tree, and he quit the pills. Boom, done.
Was he smoking it or taking edibles?
He was smoking that shit, old school style. I was like, yo, man, like, keep getting the pills and give them to me. I'll give you money. He wouldn't do it. I was like, ugh. I was like, I thought you was a badass. You fucking lame. Come on, man.
Trying to shame him. Let's
get some. I know. I was like, you want money or not? Guess he didn't want to sell me pills, whatever.
How's your strength coming together? Aren't you getting a string going?
We'll see. All right. I'm working on it. I'm talking to different places and shit, so we'll see. We'll see. The people I'm talking to, the weed is good, though. I had my cousin try it out, and he was like, it's legit. So right now I'm in the dating stage, so we'll see.
Nice.
We'll see. We'll see.
If you're looking to relocate over in Mississippi, Natchez, they will pay you a monthly stipend and a relocation fee to just move there. And so they're saying, with all the people working remotely, why not come to Natchez over in Mississippi? They'll pay you $6,000 to head over there.
There you go. Yo, especially if like you're in a... Yo, if you're... Because if you're in a neighborhood that's getting developed and shit, they're fucking... They'll be paying cash to leave, just free it up so they can get more money for the apartment. So you can take that and double dip. Get your 15 grand here, your 6 grand there, your fucking moving shit, and be a millionaire. 20 grand in Mississippi is like being a millionaire, dude. You're fucking good.
Oh yeah, they do point out here that the cost of living is much less. You can get a house, $150,000.
Dude, I was stuck trying to go somewhere. I was looking down in Mississippi at the Delta, and like the houses that they had were big as fuck, son, for like nothing. You could buy it outright cash. That's how low some of that shit was. And then, like, the extra swagged out houses were fucking $152. I was like, damn, son. You just got to drive an hour and a half to the fucking airport. It was a problem. So, kind of ixnayed that shit.
Well, again, the hard sell here, Natchez, they're saying it's one of the oldest continuous settlements on the Mississippi.
Where the fuck is Natchez at?
I mean, it's on the Mississippi River.
On the Mississippi.
River. Yeah, and they're saying it best New Orleans. It's bigger, flashier. I don't know about that, but Natchez.
Hey, I don't know. Ain't shit. Man. Everyone's working. It does make sense.
Look at it. Give you the cash.
If I wasn't committed to here, maybe I would move down to Natchez. But stuck here in Michigan. Fucking pot committed now.
All right, if you look at your text, you'll see a quick video of some people who are... No, it's not the good news. It will be in a second. But, I mean, I guess on a certain level. Right. It's these rage rooms that are gaining some popularity with everybody home and frustrated. Some people are going into these rooms and just smashing TVs with a sledgehammer. And there's one out here in Westlake Village, California. The only one in California that offers some sort of therapy as well.
Really?
But you go in there and
you just
breaking
shit. Plate at a wall. You can,
I guess it's...
You can play the audio on your end. Like, they're just... They look like they're wearing like beekeeper outfits. And then they're just breaking glasses.
Yeah. Smash. Whoa.
This is California's first.
Yeah, they're looking at breaking shit.
People pay for this. Just go out in the backyard, throw a bottle.
I know. Like, and I've busted up some shit, and then after a minute, you're just like, okay, like, all right, the TV's broken. You know what I mean? Like,
you've smashed a TV.
After a while, yeah. I don't know, fucking in my 20s. Come on, you've never like broken a TV or thrown it off a roof or fucking some shit like that?
Oh, sure. I used to love throwing fluorescent lights. Okay.
All right, there you go. Oh, yeah, they pop in a special way.
Explosion.
They give you that. Yeah. That's the good stuff.
Well, it's an option.
That's the good.
There could be a rage room in your area if you want to release some tension.
I'm looking for a deprivation tank, the exact opposite of a rage room. The sensory deprivation tanks.
Oh, yeah.
Where you just float.
They've got to have that in Detroit.
Those
guaranteed.
Shits are fucking therapeutic.
Guaranteed.
I'll look around. I'm sure there is one. But, like, them shits are actually therapeutic. I understand the rage room, but, like, I don't know. Just breaking a thing that I don't feel like it's really going to make me feel much better. You know what I mean?
Not really.
Especially if it's just a plate. They're like, I'm going to go break a plate. I'll be over here. And they just give me some fucking piece of shit plate that they got from fucking Goodwill. Like, wow, I broke a Goodwill plate. Yeah. That solves me not being able to go into the office and work. That was way better. Uh-huh. Thank God for that plate.
Well, there's a toilet out in the street not too far from here. Maybe I'll take a hammer to it, see if it'll feel any better. Smash.
Yeah, I mean,
who knows?
I feel like that's fun for a second, but like, I wouldn't get in my car and drive somewhere to go do it. You know what I mean? Like, that's nothing I would commute to, like, and then pay money for.
It looks like the guy
go
here.
Go break my own shit.
That's with his girlfriend. Oh, looks like a date night. Smashing shit up.
Oh, my God. Jesus fucking Christ. California. All right.
I do have the good news.
There it is, rage room. But the people that go to rage rooms are the same people that, like, fucking someone will cut in front of them in line and they won't say anything and they'll just mutter for fucking 30 minutes. You know what I mean? Those are the people. That's what rage rooms are for. Like, you're walking around with a bunch of fucking anger.
Bottle up and explode.
Over all these little stupid shits. Yeah. Yeah, totally. Totally, dude. All right, what else?
Well, I've got the good news.
And now, time for good news.
All right, again, back to your text. But I do have this young girl, 14 years old, out of Colombia, fighting off three armed robbers with a machete.
Damn, son.
And I don't have her name.
Let me take a look.
So you'll see it right away. But here, let me play it here too. And sorry, it's the guys speaking in Spanish.
Los delincuentes, porque les quiero mostrar el video de lo ocurrido en el barrio inglés con una niña de 14 años que sacó corriendo a los delincuentes.
Llegaron a atacar. Yeah, she was fucking. She had a machete. I'm telling you, man. My neighbor was this little short dude from, I don't know, like Guatemala or some shit like that. And he kept a machete on him. Anytime there was problems with the fucking bums or some shit, he'd be out there with the machete chasing them away.
Yeah, that's
it really gets the point across. You know what I mean? There's nothing like a machete that fucking,
it speaks for itself.
Makes people chill. Yeah.
Oh, there's G with the machete. Steer clear. Yeah. But again, just to be clear, so this young lady, she's sitting there with her mom in their, I don't know, their little candy shop or something, and these guys come in with helmets, and then she just not hesitate. She just goes right after him with the machete, scared him off.
Yeah. She wasn't having that shit. She was like, nah, bro. We worked too damn hard for this motherfucking candy. No, sir.
I like that, though. That's the way you do it. Do not hesitate. She's not scared. Nope. Fuck those guys.
I know, right? Good for her. That's the news.
You're listening to the All Out Show with you.
Jade 45. All right. That was Jade 45. That was the show. The All Out Show, in case you're a first-time listener, we go all out. I'd like to thank John motherfucking Keenan. Shanice, my name is Jude. You can follow the show at All Out Show on everything. And follow me at One More Jude on Instagram. I probably won't be posting shit for a second because I'm fucking hungover from drugs. But once I get unhungover, I'll post like a champ. Yeah. All right. Let's go.